In this video, we're going to go over how to graph a line using the slope-intercept method. We went over lines in the form y equals mx plus b and found out lines written in this form, where it's solved for y, the coefficient of x was the slope, so m was the slope, and we'll write that as a fraction when we want to say what the slope is, and b, that's the place where the line crosses the y-axis. So the y-intercept is actually the point 0b. And so our steps will be to first plot a point, which will be the y-intercept, and then to use the slope to get another point on the line. All right, so we will plot the point 0b, then we'll use the slope written as a fraction to find one or more points. So let's go over an example. So here's an example. Graph y equals 2x minus 3. The first thing we want to do is state m and b. So m, the slope, is 2, and b is negative 3. Now, since the slope is written, it's just a number. It's just the number 2. But it'll be easier to write that as a fraction if we want to use it as the rise over the run. So now let's get out some graph paper and try it. I'm going to do a rough sketch of the graph, but I suggest you use real graph paper and always remember to mark the x and y axis and at least one number on the x axis and one number on the y axis. I'll go ahead and also label that 4 up here. So we're going to start with, always start with where it crosses the y axis, because you know that's one point on the line. So it says that the y-intercept is going to be 0, negative 3. So we're just going to plot that point down here, 0, negative 3. So here's the 0, negative 3. And I'm going to use the slope. Now if I wrote it as 2 over 1, both positive, I know it's going to be slanting up to the right. So if you want, you could just make a little note. You know it's going to go upward, looking from left to right. All right, so remember, it's rise over run. So the run, the denominator is 1, so I'm going to go 1 to the right, right, and then up 2, and there's another point on my line. And I could keep doing that, over 1 and up 2 again to get another point, and over 1 and up 2. And I do this a lot because I don't always have a ruler handy, so I just plot a bunch of points. It's easier for me to connect the dots. The last step would be to draw as straight a line as you can. Use a ruler if you have some graph paper, so it's as accurate as possible. And there we have the graph of the line. Now the last thing you want to do is make sure it's slanting the right direction, which it is, it's going upward. And let's also check a point on the line to make sure it's really on, works in that equation. So for instance, I see this point here, what is that? That's over 3 and up 3. So that's the point 3, 3. And do a little check. If you put in 3 for x and 3 for y, into this equation, y equals 2x minus 3, does it work? So I'm just going to do a little check down here. I'm going to check 3, 3 and make sure it works. So that means 3 equals 2 times 3 minus 3. And yes, that's just a little check to make sure you didn't make a mistake when you were doing your slope. Let's do another problem. Y equals negative 2/3 x plus 1. So first we want to identify the slope and the y-intercept. So the slope is just the coefficient of x, which is negative 2/3. And the y-intercept, or b in this case I'm going to write, b is 1. So that means it crosses that y-axis at 0, 1. Now notice the slope is a negative number, so it's going to slant downward. And we want to write the slope as a fraction. We want to decide where to put that negative sign. For the slope to be negative, either the numerator or the denominator has to be negative. So we could write it as negative 2 over positive 3, or you could write it as positive 2 over negative 3. I'm going to start off by writing it this way. And then we're going to go ahead and make a graph. All right, so here's a rough sketch of an x and y axis. Remember, we're going to start off always by plotting a point we know that it's on the line, and that will be the y-intercept. So if b is 1, the y-intercept goes right through 0, 1 right here. And now we're going to use the slope. So I decided to, remember, this is the rise over the run. So I'm going to run positive 3 to the right, so I'm going to go over 3 to the right, and then the rise is negative 2, that means down 2, and there's another point on your graph. Now I could do it again, but I'm sort of off the paper here, over 3 and down 2, and there's another one. Now what if I had written the slope as positive 2 over negative 3? If I write it like that, that's a way of getting a point to the left of your y-axis, because if the denominator is negative, I'm going to have to go to the left, right? So I need to go to the left 3 spaces and then up 2, and I would have another point on the graph right about here. And now you try to draw an accurate line. All right, I just kind of did a freestyle line here. Make sure you use the real ruler. I can't use it with this program. So I want to do a little check just to make sure it's going through some other points. So for instance, down here I've got 3, negative 1. Let's see if that really is on the original line up here. So I'm going to check 3, negative 1 into y equals negative 2/3 x plus 1. So I'm putting in negative 1 for y and 3 for x, and convince yourself that's true because the 3's cancel, and is negative 1 equal to negative 2 plus 1? Yes, it is. So yes, it's slanting the correct direction because it's negative slanting the right way, and another point that it went through really is on that line. Here's another problem. Graph y equals negative 4x. Put the video on pause and do this problem by yourself. Okay, so what do we need to do? We need to identify the slope and the y-intercept. So the slope is negative 4. And what's the y-intercept here? Well, you don't see it. It's going to be 0. Remember, if you forget, it just means put in 0 for x. And if you put in 0 for x, y would be 0. So b is 0, which means it crosses the y-axis at 0. Now, remember, the slope needs to be written as a fraction. So we need to write that either as negative 4 over positive 1 or anything else that reduces to negative 4, or you could write it as positive 4 over negative 1, etc. So now we're going to graph it. Alright, so we're going to start off with where it crosses the y-axis, because we know that's at least one point on the line. It's going to be 0, 0 in this case. Then we're going to use the slope negative 4 over 1. So remember, it's rise over run. So in the run, I'm going positive 1, and then I'm going down 4. So I've got a point here. I'm going to go off the graph if I do that again. So how about if I think of the slope as positive 4 over negative 1 instead? That way I can get a point to the left of the y-intercept. So I'm going negative 1, and then up 4, and I have this point right here. And then we draw the line through those 3 points. Remember when you draw the line to put arrows on it, because the line goes forever. And let's just do a quick checkpoint. This point up here is negative 1, positive 4, right? Negative 1, 4, and let's just make sure that checks in the original equation. So we're going to check to make sure negative 1, 4 is in y equals negative 4x. Remember, that was the original equation? So we're going to put in 4 for y and negative 1 for x, and you could verify that's true, right? 4 equals 4. So you know that it's going through some correct points. Let's do one more problem. Graph y equals negative 2. Well, we did this in a different video. This was a special case, and what this says is y is always negative 2. So you could plot some points, let x be any number you want, 0, 1, and 2 for instance, graph those 3 points, and if you do that, you should get a horizontal line. But we could also do it by the slope and y-intercept method. If you do that, you don't see the x at all in the when I've written it as y equals negative 2, so remember that means the slope is 0. And the slope is 0, that reminds us that is the horizontal line. And the y-intercept is negative 2. So you could also use the slope-intercept method to graph like this, y equals negative 2 down here. And then if you want to use the slope 0, it means You could write the slope as 0 over 1, for instance. So that means you go over 1, not up or down at all. Over 1 again, over 1 again. And notice basically I'm getting the same order pairs as I did if I was just going to plot these three order pairs I showed at the beginning. And so there we've got the line y equals negative 2 using either method. It's this horizontal line.